हेलो एवरीवन, चलो लेट्स डू हाउ टू फाइंड लास्ट टू डिजिट ऑफ अ नंबर। ठीक है, दैट सेशन विल बी अराउंड ऑफ 15 मिनट्स। सो टू फाइंड लास्ट टू डिजिट ऑफ अ नंबर यू हैव टू नो फॉर द फ्यू केसेस फर्स्ट। दैट इज इफ द नंबर इज एंडिंग विद जीरो, राइट, देन लास्ट टू डिजिट विल एंड विद जीरो। सो लास्ट टू डिजिट विल बी 00। सो इफ आई एम इंटरेस्टेड इन 3570 raised to power 579, then the last two digits of this number will be 00. So if the number is ending with 5, then there's a two cases are there. If the number is ending with 5, last two digits are always 25. Except when tens digit of base and power of number are odd, then last two digits are 75. Okay, so for each and every case last two digit is 25, except when the tens digit of base is odd and the power is odd, only in that case the last two digit are going to be 75. Let's take an example here. So if I am interested in, let's say, 55 raised to power 65. So now if you see here, you will first check out, is the power odd? Yes. Is the tens digit odd? Yes. So last two digits are going to be 75. If any of the answer would have been no, then the last two digit would have been 25. Third case is when the number is ending with 1, right? So if the number is ending with 1, then the answer is very simple. Let's take an example, it will be more clear. If I'm saying 57491 raised to power 373, then the last two digits, in that the unit digit will be 1 and the tens digit will be obtained by the product of tens digit of base and unit digit of power. So 3 into 9 is 27, and from that you will take 7 here. So these are the last two digits. You know, this is special case when the unit digit of the number is 1, then how to find the last two digits. Let's take one more example here. So if I am saying 54741 raised to power 349. Now for last two digit, right, the unit digit will be 1. And for the tens digit, you'll have to multiply tens digit of base and unit digit of power. 4 into 9 is 6. And from there, you will get 6. Last two digits are 61. So these were special cases when the number is ending with 0, 5 or 1. Now, let's make some rules. The rules which we had made for unit digit, exactly similar rules will be there for last two digits. So if you have to find last two digits of any number, then only two digits of the base are going to make any difference. So last two digits of 35479 raised to power 5473, the answer for last two digits of this will be same as of 79 raised to power 73. You will just retain the two digits of the base and you will retain the two digits of the power. That's it. Answer is not going to change if you will leave all other digits. You know, they don't have any use for us. Second rule. The last two digits have got cyclicity of 20. Last one digit ki cyclicity 40. Last two digit cyclicity is of 20. So let's take it from the top. Hamare paas the number which we had was 79 raised to power 73. So last two digit of this will be same as 79 raised to power. 73 you will divide with 20. So 73 divided by 20, the remainder is 13. So 79 raised to power 13. So this will have exactly same last two digits. Cyclicity of 20 means if I'm taking 54 raised to power 21, it has got same last two digit as of 54 raised to power 1. If I am saying, and this will have same last two digit as 54 raised to power 41 or 54 raised to power 81, right? The cyclicity is of 20. So if I am interested in, let's say 17 raised to power 82, what will be the last two digits? You will say cyclicity 20. This is same as 17 raised to power 2, which is 17 square 289, and last two digit for 17 raised to power 82 will be 89. Okay, so that's cyclicity of 20 is there. Okay, so steps are, you will first reduce the base and the power. You will take only two digits. Second step is you will divide the power with 20 and retain only the remainder, right? So whatever first, second, third we have done, based on that we'll be finding the last two digit of other numbers. Finding last two digit of a number ending with 13, 3, 7 or 9. Trick for this is convert them in unit digit 1. So you will convert them in unit digit 1 and then you are going to apply the rule for last two digit of number ending with 1. Let's take example here. If I am interested in 89 raised to power, let's say 89 or 89 raised to power 90. Now, number power is 90. Now base unit digit is 9. So you will write this as 89 square raised to power 45. Last two digits for 89 square is, that is same as of 11 square, that is 21. So 21 raised to power 45. Now this is, now number is ending with 1. So last two digit is easy to find. That is, it will end with 1 and you will multiply the unit of power and tens of base. So 2 5 is 10, so that is 0 1. So last two digits for the number is 0 1. Okay, I hope the things are clear till here. Let's take, before we take more example on this, one small rule what is there is, you should know the last two digits of 1 to 25 square. Okay. In square, the last two digits repeats in a cycle of 25. So how I found the last two digit of 89 square? So 11 square last two digit will be same as of 50 minus 11 square last two digit will be same as of 50 plus 11 and will be same as of 100 minus 11 square. Last two digits in each case is same. So if I talk about 73, or let's say I am talking about 79 square, last two digit will be same as of 100 minus 79 square, that is 21 square, which is 441, or last two digits are 41. Okay, so this concept related to square you should be aware of. Last two digits of 59 square, that is same as 50 plus 9 or 9 square, which is 81. Last two digits of 64 square, that is same as 50 plus 14 or 14 square, that is 96. Last two digits of, let's say 33 square, that is same as 50 minus 17 or 17 square, which is 289 or 89. Okay, if required you can pause the video, just try to grasp, practice more on this before proceeding ahead. So we are coming back, when the number is ending with the digits 379, then how to find the last two digits? Let's take an example, one more example. If I am saying the number is 543 raised to power 543, right? Or instead of 543, let's make it 453. 453. So first thing is you just leave only the two digits. So this is 43 raised to power 53. Second is divide power by 20. So last two digits are same as 43 raised to power 13. Now you have to convert 43 into the terms of unit digit as 1. So what you will do is this thing is same as 43 into 43 square raised to power 13, sorry, raised to power 6. Now 43 square, last two digits are, that is same as 7 square, which is 49. So this is 43 into 49 raised to power 6. Now 43 into 49 raised to power 6 is 49 square raised to power 3. 49 square raised to power 3. 49 square is 1. So 1 raised to power 3. 1 raised to power 3, last 3 digits, 2 digits are 1 only. So 49 into 1, answer is 49. Okay, here I am writing all the steps. If you don't have, you don't need to write the steps, then you can easily find the answer within 30 seconds. Okay, let's take one more question here. So if I'm interested in 3477 raised to power, let's take 3477. Now this is same as 77 raised to power 77, which is same as 77 raised to power 17, right? Now you will have to take squares of 77, but power odd hai yahan par, so you can't just take the squares at present, right? So up 17 you will, 77 you will take out, left is 77 raised to power 16. So this is 77 into 77 square raised to power 8. 77 square is same as 23 square. 23 is 529, so 29 is the last two digits. So 77 into 29 raised to power 8. Right? Last two digits of 29 is same as of 21. 21 square is 441. So this is 77 into 41 raised to power 4. Now, this you know, right? This is 77 into 1 will be there. 4 fours are 16 and 6 will be there. Last two digits of these numbers. So you'll have to multiply 7 into 1, that is 7. And after that, you need to multiply this, that is 7, 6 are 42 and 7, 6 are 42. Right? So 7 ones are 7. And then you will take 7, 6 are. So what you will take is, first I'm taking this 7 into 6, which is 42. And then I'm taking is 7 into 1, which is 7. 42 and 7, that is 49. And 9 will be retained. And thus 97 is the last two digit of the given number. Let's take one more example in this. If I'm interested in 3249 raised to power 57. Now this number is same as 49 raised to power 57, which is same as 49 raised to power 17. Now this is same as 49 into 49 raised to power 16, which is same as 49 into 01 raised to power 8, which is same as 49 into 01, or answer is 49. Right? This is, if you get into flow, you can solve each question in 30 seconds. This was, so number when ending with 0, 5, number ending with 1. And then we took on the case if the number is ending with 3, 7, 9. Just convert it first into number ending with 1 and then apply the same law which we have used before for 1. What if the number is ending with even digit? Agar wo even digit ke saath end kar raha hai, you know, number is ending with 2, 4, 6, 8, then how to solve it? So in case the number is ending with 2468, the rule is take out 2, take out all the powers of 2. ठीक है, सो है ना, सुनने में बहुत सिंपल है भी एक्चुअली, दिस इज ऑल्सो वेरी इजी. लेट्स सी हियर इफ द क्वेश्चन इज आई एम इंटरेस्टेड इन 5, 3, 4, 6 raised to power 89, राइट. नाउ हाउ टू सॉल्व दिस, सो यू फर्स्ट रिड्यूस इट डाउन, है ना, रिड्यूस इट डाउन टू दैट टू डिजिट ओनली. सो दिस इज सेम एज 46 raised to power 89. This is same as 46 raised to power 9. Now, write it down as 2 raised to power 9 into 23 raised to power 9. Right? 2 raised to power 9, that is 512. Last two digits are 12 into 23 raised to power 9. That is 23 into. Then this is 23 plus 23 square raised to power 4. So this is 12 into 23 into. 23 square is 529. So that is 29 raised to power 4, and 29 raised to power 4 is same as 41 raised to power 2. 41 raised to power 2 is same as 81. Right? 41 is same as 9. So this is 81. Now you can find the last two digits of this by multiplying them. Okay? So in case when you are multiplying this, so easy way is, see this is 2 and 3. So 2, 3 is 6. Now you will multiply 2 and 3. You know, these numbers only you have to multiply. So you go with 2 with 2 and this 3 with 1. So 2 2s are 4, 3 1s are 7. So this is 7. 76 into 81. Again, let's apply on this. So 6 into 1, that is 6. Now this 6 will go with 8 and this 1 will go with 7. 6 8s are 48 and plus 7. That is 55, and 5 will be there. So answer is 56. Right? That's to find last two digits of a number with even digits. Right? Let's take one more question in this. If the number is, let's say this is 5, 9, 8, 4 raised to power 97. So first reduce it down into the simplest form. Simpler form of this is 84 raised to power 97, which is same as 84 raised to power 17. Now in this you take the power of 2's common. So this is, you will factorize this. This is 2 square into, this is 42, 21 raised to power 17, which is 2 raised to power 34 into 21 raised to power 17, right? Now you will work out on it. 2 raised to power 34, last two digit will be same as 2 raised to power 14 into 21 raised to power 17. Last two digits will be, this is ending with 1 and 2 into 7, right? The rule of 1. So 2 into 7 is 14. Last two digits are 41. So 2 raised to power 14. If you don't know, then break it down. This is 2 raised to power 10 into 2 raised to power 4 into 41, right? 2 raised to power 10 is 1024 into 16 into 41. Now solve it out. This is 6 4s are 24, 2 is carried, 6 1s are 6, 4 1s are 4, that is 10, and 2 carried, that is 12. So 24, 24 into 24, so 24 square is 576, last two digits are 76. That's it, only these many rules were there. Now besides what we have done, only one very very small exception is also there. And you have to take care of that exception. Okay? Exception is related to the cyclicity of 20. Cyclicity of 20 is not applicable for a particular number with particular power. Okay? That is, if the number is in form of 4n plus 2, let's say the number is 18, which is in form of 4n plus 2, and the power is 20k plus 1. That is, if power is 21, as per our cyclicity rule, answer should have been 18. But in this particular case, answer will not be 18, but answer will be 50 plus 18. That is, answer will be 68. Last two digits are 68. If I am saying for 16 raised to power 21, answer will be 16 only, because rule is only for numbers in form of 4n plus 2. If I am saying 18 raised to power 22, answer will be same as 18 square. 18 square is 324, which is 24. Why? Because the power is not 20k plus 1, but 20k plus 2. So, ye har number per cyclicity is okay, except if the number is in form of 4n plus 2 with a particular power of 20k plus 1. Only in that case, answer will not be the number, but number plus 50. Okay? So, let me tell you this again. If I am doing 11 raised to power 41, last two digits are 11. 12 raised to power 41, last two digits are 41. Sorry, last two digits are 12. 13 raised to power 41, last two digits are 13. 14 raised to power 41. Now here is the catch. Last two digits are 14 plus 50, that is 64. Right? Only this small exception is here. With that exception, all the rules are covered already. And let's do some practice question. Okay? Please note down all this rule and let's do some practice question. So last two digits of 2 raised to power 2. So what you need to do is divide the power. First retain only two digits. Divide the power with 2. Remainder is 2. Last two digits are 0, 4. These are the last two digits. 42 raised to power 84. Now you all already know the trick. So this will be 42 raised to power 84 divided by 20, that is 4, which is same as 2 into 21 raised to power 4. 2 raised to power 4 into 21 raised to power 4. 2 raised to power 4, that is 16. 21 raised to power 4. So 21 raised to power 4 is 1 will be there, and 2 fours are 8, 81. Multiply them, you will get your answer. 6 ones are 6. Now 6 ones are 6, 8s are 48, and 1 ones are 1. So this is 49. Answer is 96. Right? So first go, what I am doing is 6 into 1, unit with unit. In the second go, what I am doing is this one with the tens now, and this one with the tens here. Right? So this is, you are getting your answer. Let's take this case. 87 raised to power 37. First, divide power with 20. So, remainder is 17. Second, you have to bring it. Odd number hai. So, this odd number, bring it with number ending with 1. So, what you are getting is, this is 87 is common. And this is 87 square raised to power 16. Sorry, raised to power 8. 87 square is same as 13 square, which is 69. So this is 87 into 69 raised to power 8. Now 69 is same as 19. 19 square is 361. So this is 87 into 61 raised to power 4. This is 87 into 6 fours are 24, and ending with 1, that is 41. So this is, once you will do the practice, you know, number ending with 1, so tens digit and ones digit you will multiply, that is 24, and the 1 is already there, right? In this also easy, that is unit with unit first, that is 7, and then is unit with tens, so you will multiply unit with tens and unit with tens. So 4 sevens are 28 plus 8, that is 36. So 36, 6 will come here. So these are the last two digits. Right? One more. 86 raised to power 77. So 86 raised to power 77. This is an even number. So you'll write this as 2 raised to power 77 into 43 raised to power 77. Or before that, you will divide 77 by 20. So this is same as 86 raised to power 17. This is 2 raised to power 17 into 43 raised to power 17. 2 raised to power 17 is 2 raised to power 10 into 2 raised to power 7. 2 raised to power 10 is 1024. 2 raised to power 7, that is 64, 128. So that is 28 into. Now 43 raised to power 17 is same as 43 into 43 square raised to power 8. Now this is 24 into 28. You know, you can multiply it here. 4 8s are 32, 3, 2 4s are 8, and 2 8s are, this is 16, and that is 24, 24 and 3, that is 27 into. Right? So this is one more. 43 is there. And 43 square, that is 7 square. 7 square is 49. So this is 49 raised to power 8. Right? 49 square will give me 1. So this is 72. First you multiply this. So this is 2 3s are 6. Now 2 4s are 8. And 3 7s are 21. 21 and 8 is 29. That is giving me 96. 49 raised to power 8. That is 49 square, which is 01 raised to power 4. Which is 1. So your answer is 96. Okay, let's take a question which was asked in a competitive exam, and it's a good question. So question is, find the minimum value of x for which y is fully divisible by 70 square. Or in terms, it's saying that 63 raised to power 63 minus x upon 4900 is an integer, right? So you have to find value of x for which this is true, minimum value of x. So one thing is, if you'll see the denominator, I'm writing it down as, so this is 63 raised to power 63 minus x upon 49 into 100. Now the first part, this is fully divisible by 49, and thus x has to be fully divisible by 49, or we can say that x is multiple of 49, right? Now second is, it has to end with 00. 00 means that whatever are the last two digits of this number, okay, x will also have the same last two digits, right? Once the last two digits are same, the numbers get subtracted and you'll have 00 in the end, or the numerator will become multiple of 100. So the question is, what are the last two digits of 63 raised to power 63? 63 raised to power 63. This will be same as of 63 raised to power 3, right? So 63 raised to power 3 is same as 63 square into 63. 63 square is same as 13 square, you know, 50 plus 13. So 13 square. 13 square is 69. So this is 69 into 63, right? Solve this. 9 3s are 27. 7 is there. Now you'll multiply unit with tens. 9 6s are 54. And unit with tens. 54 and 18, that is 72. 72 and 2 was carry forward, that is 74. From 74, 4 will be here. So last two digits of 63 raised to power 63 is 47. Thus, x has last two digits as 47. Now here will be heat and trial, you know, 49 ka multiple and should end with 47. So this is 49 threes are 147. So minimum value of x, minimum value of x is 147. Okay. So this was topic on how to find the last two digits. Okay. Thank you. I hope you enjoyed the session.